Hello students, today we are going to solve some textual exercises of chapter 2 and 3 which are important for your semester 1 exam. Firstly, page number 31, question number 3, study the sentences in the column A and B. Compare the sentences in A to the one in B. Who is the doer of the action in every case? Is the doer mentioned in A or in B? So if we see first column, Meghna was swept away and the waves swept Meghna away. So in this, who is the doer? So in column B, doer is wave as it swept Meghna away. In second, Elma's grandfather was hit on the head and something hit Elma's grandfather on the head. Here the doer is something hit. 60 visitors were washed away and the waves washed away the 60 visitor. Again, in the column B, the waves are the doer. No animal carcasses were found and people did not find any animal carcass. Again, here doer is people. Notice the verbs in A, that is swept away, was hit, were washed away, were found. They are in the passive voice. Whenever you see words like was, were, had, been, had, it shows that it is a passive voice. In these sentences, the focus is not on the person who does the action. Whereas in B, the doer of the action is named. The verbs are in the active form. Here you can see swept, hit, washed, find. They all are in active form. So the sentences which are in column B are in active voice, whereas the sentences in column A are passive voice. Now, say whether the following sentences are in active or passive voice. First, someone stole my bicycle. This is an active voice as the doer of action is named and verb are in active form. Second, the tire were deflated by the traffic police. Here the word were shows that it is a passive voice. Focus is not on the person. Third, I found it last night in a ditch near my house. This is active voice as doer of action is named and verb are in a active form. Fourth, it had been thrown there. Had been is used in passive voice, so this sentence is in passive voice. Fifth, my father gave it to the mechanic. This sentence is active voice as the verbs are in active form and doer of the action is named. And the last one is the mechanic repaired it for me. Again, it is a active voice. Verbs are in active form and doer of action is named. Next is page number 32, question 1. Suppose you are one of the volunteers who went to the Andaman and Nicobar Island for relief work after the tsunami. You work in the relief camp distributing food, water and medicines among the victims. You listen to the various stories of bravery of ordinary people even as they fight against odds to bring about some semblance of normalcy in their lives. You admire their grit and determination. Write a diary entry. So suppose Andaman and Nicobar Island were hit by the tsunami and you are one of the volunteer who help people, you have to share your experience with people. So write a diary entry. As I have already taught you the format of diary entry, you have to write date, time and place. So put today's date, time and place and then start. The killer tsunami struck these islands 5 days ago, but the victims are being brought in even now. Each one of has a story to tell. The stories are hair-raising as well as heartening or inspiring. Many were determined to start a new life. They don't want to stay in the camp for long. They feel small because living on charity was disgraceful. Most of them want to return to their cottage, which are no more there. And to get a fishing boat to earn livelihood, one woman, though old, recalled how she had saved a child from drowning. So, as the event has already taken place, you have to write diary in past tense. So, you have to share details that tsunami hit Andaman and Nicobar Island 5 days ago and still victims are brought there. Everyone shared their story, which are shocking and some are very inspiring. All the people want to start a new life, and as they are living in charity, they don't feel respected because they want to earn their livelihood and want to go back to their home. And one of the old lady shared her experience that she saved a child from drowning. At the last, you need to write goodnight diary, and after leaving one line, write your name. Page number 45 in comics, what the characters speak is put in bubbles. This is a direct narration. As in the chapter 3, glimpses of the past, you see that bubbles are there in which dialogues are written. That is direct speech. When we report what the characters speak, we use the method of indirect narration. But when we tell this to another people, we use indirect narration. Let's see this example and we'll try to solve two more questions like this. So first farmer, why are your men taking away the entire crop? Second farmer, your men have taken away everything. Officer, you are still in arrears. If you don't pay tax, next week I'll send you to jail. So here's a conversation of three people, two farmers and an officer. This is in direct speech. Let's try to convert into indirect speech. Let's start. The first farmer. Then as you can see, it is an interrogative sentence. So write asked. The officer. They both are asking it to officer. So the first farmer asks the officer why. Then you need to bring subject at first. That your man will be converted into his men. Then verb is are. In indirect speech, it will be converted into were, as men is in plural form. And the entire sentence will be same. The first farmer asks the officer why his men were taking away the entire crop. Second is, the second farmer said that your will be converted into their, man, have will be converted into had, taken away everything. Now the officer is replying to them. So officer replied that you are still in arrears, so you will be converted into they, are will be converted into were, they were still in arrears. Then the officer is warning them, so he warned them that if they, you will be converted into they, don't will be converted into did, not pay tax, next week will be converted into the following week, I will be converted into he would, send again, you will be changed into them to jail. Let's try another example. First man, we must educate our brothers. So the first man said that we will be converted into they, must educate, are will be converted into their brothers. Second man, and try to improve their material conditions. As you can see that second person has added something to first one, so we have written added. The second man added that they should try to improve their material conditions. Third man suggested that they must convey our grievances to the British Parliament. Last one, first soldier, the white soldier gets huge pay, mansions and servants. So the first soldier said that the white soldier gets is the base form, it will be converted into past form. So got huge pay, mansions and servant. Second soldier, we get a pittance and slow promotion. So the second soldier remarked that they again, get will be converted into got, a pittance and slow promotions. Third soldier, who are the British to abolish our customs? So, as you can see, it is an interrogative sentence. So, you need to add asked. The third soldier asked who the British are will be converted into were. Who the British were to abolish our customs. Here R will be converted into were and R will be converted into there. Next is construct a story by using hints given below. We have already understood how to write a story. You need to give a suitable title and a moral. So let's read the hints. On the basis of it, we'll try to construct a story. Fox fell into well. Goat arrived. Wanted to know where the water was sweet. Fox said that water was sweet. Invited her into well. Goat went to the well. Fox rode on her back and came out. Befooled her. Goat remember her mother's word. So there's a dash, that doesn't mean you need to add one or two word. Instead, you need to add at least 3 to 4 sentences. So once a fox fell into a well accidentally, she thought how to get out of the well. A goat arrived there by the chance. She looked into the well. She asked the fox if the water was sweet. The cunning fox played a trick. She told a lie that the water was very, very sweet and she had had enough of it. The foolish goat also wanted to taste the water. The fox invited her into the well. The goat reached there soon. Now the fox rode on the goat's back and climbed out of the well. Then she thanked the goat for help. The goat was reminded of her mother's word that she must never go by the advice of a stranger. So from this story, we learn that we must never trust a stranger. Here, revision of chapter 2 and 3 gets over. We'll solve textual exercises of chapter 4 and 5 in the next video.